We will first start with the publisher node. We studied that nodes are information or data processing units. Sure, but where does the information come from? Who generates the information? A ROS node that generates information is called a publisher. A publisher uses one or more ROS topics to communicate the generated information to other ROS nodes. In the context of ROS-based robotic applications, these nodes are typically used to process raw sensory information, for example, from a camera, motor encoders, distance sensors, and so on. Once the raw sensory information is processed according to the needs of the desired application, it is published to a ROS topic, hence the name publisher. With this basic idea, let's now look at the example output of the ROS node info node underscore one command. We first see that the node name is displayed as node underscore one. Then the publication section, we can see the topics that the node is publishing and the associated topic type. A little further below in the output, we can also see a confirmation of the same in the connections section. It can be seen that topic underscore one has an outbound direction to node underscore two. In other words, node one writes to topic one. We have seen information about a publisher node, but how do we implement one? We will now look at an example code for a ROS publisher. Before we proceed, a small disclaimer. In all explanation where there is code, myself, along with other instructors, will only explain the relevant portions in the context of this course. The portions we skip in some code sections are, of course, necessary for the code to work, but the details of those are skipped parts are beyond the scope of this course. All right, in this example, we will see the implementation of a ROS publisher node. First, we list the required Python imports. The ROSPy import is to ensure all the ROS-specific Python modules are made available to this node. Then, we also import the message type string so that we can publish a message of this type from our ROS node. We then define the publisher object using the ROSPy.publisher function. As you can see, we pass the topic name and the topic type as the first and second arguments to this function. These are exactly what we saw in the publication section of the node information output. Note that the publisher object is only an information placeholder. The information can only be published when it is associated with a ROS node. This is done via the ROSPy.init_node function. We pass the name of the node as the first argument to this function. Finally, we set the frequency with which the defined topic is published by this ROS node using the ROSPy.rate function. The argument to this command indicates the topic frequency in hertz. Having declared the required placeholders, we can now start filling in the desired information to be published. Then, the desired topic can be published using the publish function of the publisher object. And the function rate.sleep ensures the topic is published at the specified frequency. In this example case, the frequency is set to 10 hertz. Finally, the code for the publisher node is put into a main module in Python, following the standard Python syntax. It does seem daunting at the beginning to remember all these syntaxes and declarations. Don't worry, in your installations, you have been provided with template codes which ensure all the relevant syntaxes are in place. This way, you can focus purely on the functional concepts and the syntax will come by practice. Having learned about publisher nodes in the first part of this module, we will now turn towards subscriber nodes. A ROS subscriber node typically receives information from a topic. This is achieved by subscribing to a topic, hence the name subscriber node. Whenever information on a topic is refreshed, a subscriber node uses a topic callback function to process the received information. In the context of ROS-based robotic applications, subscriber nodes can be used for tasks such as monitoring system states. For example, a subscriber node can be used to monitor the joint limits of a robot manipulator and raise an alert if the task being performed leads to the robot getting too close to one of its joint limits. Let us now take a quick look at an example where information regarding a subscriber node is printed. In this case, we can see that node_2 has subscribed to topic_1 as indicated in the subscription section. Again, a little further below, in the connection section, we see that topic_1 has an inbound connection to node_2 from node_1. In other words, node_2 is reading from topic_1. Similar to the publisher node, let's also take a quick look at the code for the subscriber node. We first have the relevant Python imports. Then we have something unique to a subscriber node, namely the topic callback function. Notice that this function has an argument data. This argument corresponds to the data structure of the topic to which the node subscribes to. It is in this function that the received information is processed as required by the ROS application. Subsequently, the subscriber node is initialized with the rospy.init_node function. Following the node initialization, the subscriber object is created using the rospy.subscriber function call. This function takes the topic to which the node subscribes to, the topic type, and the subscriber callback function as arguments. And finally, the ROS and Python specific definitions and function calls. All right, we have now learned about two important building blocks of a ROS application, namely the publisher node and a subscriber node. The publisher node writes to one or more ROS topics, and the subscriber node reads from one or more ROS topics, with each subscription processed via a respective callback function. Now we know how to write publisher and subscriber nodes with standard ROS topic types. In the next video, we will learn how to create our own ROS topic type and use them in combination with ROS publishers and subscribers. After that, we will write our very first ROS application. See you soon.